Hello everybody, welcome back to the Metal Scrubber channel. And again, too bad my phone holder is still not here, because I just scrubbed a total zinc roof. I was walking with my family yesterday. It was beautiful weather and someone renovated the front door. There was a little zinc roof on top of that. So I just asked him if I could have it. So I took the angle grinder and grind it in let's say they are plugs. I'm gonna fold these like packages, small packages, like this one. So they will fit in the crucible. So yeah, there was supposed to be a scrapping video, but I cannot hold my phone and operate a angle grinder, so too bad. So this will just fit my crucible. I have some smaller pieces, so I will start the zinc melt with smaller pieces, and then each time I will add these. But first, I'm gonna stamp or make all small rolls of the larger pieces. Then I will weigh it up. And there was also some lead in this roofing material. So we have some, I guess you can call this a spout. I've got the same one. Only that is from copper, so we have one lead spout there, and it's almost 2 kilos together with the other roofing material, so that's great. Got one lead wheel weight, but it was not enough to melt. As you can see, PB from plumbum. We got one wheel weight from lead combined with the rest is almost 2 kilos. So gonna make some small rolls, and then we'll have a quick melt the zinc and the lead into bars. So see you back when everything is
made small.
See you back. Alright guys, update. I just received my new tripod, so gonna film the hammering. So it's hammer time.
Later.
So, done making some compact zinc pieces. Here it is. So this is a roof of roughly 2 by 1 meters. So let's weigh it up and after that meld it. My phone battery died just before I ended all the hammering, I guess. Not sure about that, but let's weigh it up. I think you guys can see this. Yep, 0. My guess it was at least 10 kilos. Right, so let's say this is roughly about 5 kilos. Maybe I have some. Right, so that's 5 kilos. Now let's weigh up the rest. Right, so this is 9.75. Now for the last piece, 9.75. 10.1 kilos. So, well over 10 kilos of zinc. Here we have it. That's my zinc. Let's start up the furnace and make some zinc ingots and lead ingots. See you back at the furnace. Alright you guys, back at the furnace, and it's a beautiful day to melt some metals. Very sunny. So I got my setup ready. There's a piece of cardboard to prevent the crucible sticking to the tile. Got my crucible which I used for the previous zinc melt, so I will first start out with the lead, because the zinc will just make one big mess of it. Got my lead and my zinc. So let's start make some ingots. Right guys, and before I start, wear a respirator when melting lead and zinc. They produce toxic fumes. These bars are heavy. It's almost the same weight as gold. That's one. Can I touch this? Yep. Well, maybe I should wear some gloves. Right, let's quench them. Right, let's check them out and go on to the zinc bars. Yeah, this is a pretty heavy bar. It's real nice. That's the fun about lead. Not too much shrinking on the top, so that's cool. And not going to bother cleaning this up. It's just lead, so yeah, we've got some lead bars here. We'll weigh them up after all the zinc has been poured into bars, because I've over 10 kilos of zinc. Yeah, came out pretty decent. Quite happy with this one. Nice and heavy. So and a little bit left over. Right, let's turn on back on the furnace and melt some zinc.
Wegwezen.
Roger guys, gonna let this one cool a little bit off. It's gonna come out. So let's quench the ingots. So, I think I'm almost 2 hours busy with melting. It was quite a lot. I think I've never done so much ingots before. And I hope I filmed it correctly. I got some splitters from one of the first batch I was putting in the zinc. So it was not from the lead but from the zinc. Just putting in the zinc and it splattered all the way. So now not only wearing my full face visor with the pouring, but also while adding metals in the furnace. And this is quite hot. I'll be back with some cold water. Alright, back with some cold water. Let's see what we made. So these are the big ones. I'm gonna clean them up, weigh them up and show them. Well, actually guys, not gonna clean them up. I'm still waiting for my vise. I've got a track and trace, so it will be here within a week. So then I will clean up the ingots. But for now, these ones will just go with a little bit black tarnish inside the furnace. So yeah, I can still weigh them up and show them. Right, back with scales. So let's first weigh out this big one. And zinc makes really smooth bars, so let's weigh it up. ...865 grams. Now I've got a medium sized one and they are all almost identical, I guess. 418, so let's weigh from each bar, just one, 203, 76. So let's weigh out all these ones together, are the cast iron mold bars. Do we have more? Yeah. Oh my, I got five bars, six. Six bars. Awesome. So almost 1.5 kilo, 1500 grams on the cast iron mold bars. Now let's weigh up the finger bars. I have five bars because the last pour was in a cast iron mold shape. So we have well over 1100 grams finger bars. Now for the medium sized ones. almost 2.2 kilos. Oh, don't mess up the scales. And now the big ones. I hope it's able to measure all the big ones. These are, yeah, we must be okay. So, almost 4 kilos. So let's weigh up the total. So let's say this is 5 kilos. So we have, let's say, 8.7 kilos. Started off with 10.1 kilos, but I got really a lot of slack. I will show you. Sorry guys, I got a phone call coming in. Yeah, as you can see, I have a chemical waste box here, but I don't think everything was that, yeah, I think it was a little bit hot. So my chemical waste box has been demolished now. That's not a problem. I'm not using it anyway. So, but you can see how much slack and dirt there was inside the metals. It's from the, a little bit from the lead, but a whole lot from the zinc. So let's put all those bars inside the safe, and we'll wrap it up. All right, another update. I got my new vise. I'm really happy with this. This is a Stanley Fatmax vise. I ordered it 2 weeks ago, I guess. And it can give a pressure on the jaws up to 2,200 kilos. Well, I'm not gonna generate over 2 tons of pressure. So that's about 4,500 pounds of pressure. So we got a nice surface to maybe straighten some pieces of metal or something. And yeah, I've not attached it to my working bench yet, but look at this. This is how a vise should work. All right, so let's clean up the bars. I couldn't help myself, I just had to clean the bars. I already started out with the big ones. So let's clean up some bars. Right, so that was working within 25 minutes, I guess. So I really like the new vise. Really happy with it. And it's so heavy, I can just put it on my bench and do not even need to attach it. Maybe for some heavy jobs. And I can move this one and this one, so I can even turn it when it's fixed to the bench. So really happy with that. And gotta say, bars look better when they are a little bit shined up. This is the lead. Look at it shining. Woo! And here's my zinc. So let's put it in the safe where it belongs. Be right back at the safe. Alright, so we're back at the safe together with my son. He's helping me with the camera work today. So I got my sink over here. Yeah, I think we need to rearrange it a little bit, but that's okay. Because I made 5 ingots of each size today. 1, 2, and 3. Oh, and man, look how shiny they are. They came out brilliant. Really love them. That's 3. And let's do it like this. Well, just here. 4 and 5. So I have 8 big bars now. Let's take the medium sized ones. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 bars. And 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Let's close it up. Here we go. So I think I need to make more of the medium sized ones. These are some. Right, now the finger bars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now I got the cast iron mold shapes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and even 6 of these ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then it will be like this. 6. I think I'm gonna remail this later on, but for now I'll put it here. And we got some lead. And the lead is very, very shiny. Gave this a quick wire brush. You can just almost looks like it's melting away again, but really shiny. 1 big one. And that one. And if you guys have seen, I've got some mail. What would this be? This is a sticker from Armando from the Fold. So make sure to check out his YouTube channel. He does videos about stacking, and I said, hey, that's a nice logo. And he said, I got a sticker like that. And I said, well, it's a sticker from my Fold. And that sticker should be in a vault. So let's place it there. Let me see. Peel it off. There it goes. Let's put him in the vault. Where should we put him? Here? Yeah, let's put him next now to Lady Bullion. On the snowy scrap picker. So we have another sticker added to the vault. So thank you, Armando. You're also, your fault is in my fault, so that sounds awkward, because if you have your stack in your fault, that would be awesome. Is that in my fault? Because this is my fault. That's not my fault. This is my fault. So thank you for watching. Oh, and I'm missing someone. It's not Easter anymore. I have to get the chicken back inside his safe. So my stack of zinc is growing steadily. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, leave a comment. Let me know which bar you like most. Will it be the lead bars? Or will it be some zinc bars? And I guess I will melt some brass next week. I will start out my new series, the summer series. It will cost some nice summer stuff. First one in brass. So give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment. Do not forget to subscribe. Hit the bell button to see all the meltings and see me stacking it up. And I'll see you next week. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.